Hi, my name is Veronica Alaniz, and I'm a pediatric and adolescent gynecologist at Children's Hospital Colorado. Mayer-Rokitansky-Kuster-Hauser syndrome, abbreviated MRKH, is agenesis of the Müllerian ducts, which results in an underdeveloped vagina and, in most cases, an absent uterus. Girls with MRKH have normal external female genitalia with a markedly shortened vagina. In some cases, uterine remnants are present with or without endometrium. All patients with MRKH have normal functioning ovaries, although they are sometimes found in atypical locations. MRKH is not uncommon and has an incidence of approximately 1 in 4,000 to 5,000 female births. MRKH is typically diagnosed during adolescence, during workup and evaluation for primary amenorrhea, which is defined as absence of menses at age 15, regardless of secondary sex characteristics. Evaluation of primary amenorrhea should be considered when menarche has not occurred by age 15, 3 years after thelarche, by age 13 with lack of breast development, by age 14 with signs of hirsutism, or by age 14 with a history or exam suggestive of excessive exercise or disordered eating. A typical workup for primary amenorrhea includes a thorough history, physical exam with focus on growth curves and Tanner stages, examination of the external genitalia for a patent outflow tract, pelvic ultrasound, and laboratory studies including a urine pregnancy test. Girls with MRKH have normal pubertal development, and on physical exam, there is a normal height, normal breast development, and normal body hair. Examination of the external genitalia should be performed, and visualization of the vestibule can be enhanced with labial traction, which is grasping the labia majora while gently pulling out and down. The distal vagina may appear flush as a dimple or may have some depth with a few centimeters. Speculum exams are rarely indicated in young patients and should not be performed in girls with suspected vaginal agenesis. Instead, providers can use a lubricated Q-tip or a single digit if tolerated by the patient to assess the vaginal depth. The differential diagnosis for a patient with primary amenorrhea and a shortened vagina includes obstructing vaginal or uterine anomalies, including an imperforate hymen, transverse vaginal septum, or distal vaginal agenesis. Complete androgen insensitivity syndrome, which is a difference of sex development, has a very similar presentation with an absent uterus and underdeveloped vagina. There are, however, some key differences. While both complete androgen insensitivity syndrome and MRKH have vaginal agenesis, girls with androgen insensitivity will have scant pubic hair on physical exam, a 46XY karyotype, and testosterone in the male range. Physical examination, pelvic imaging, karyotype, and testosterone will confirm the diagnosis of MRKH. Pelvic ultrasound with an abdominal approach is typically the first imaging test ordered. This will confirm absent uterus but may not detect uterine remnants. A follow-up pelvic MRI without contrast can be ordered to assess for uterine remnants. If remnants are identified, it's especially important to determine if endometrium is present. Remnants with endometrium can cause obstructive symptoms, including cyclic pelvic pain and endometriosis. These often need to be surgically removed. There are two types of MRKH. MRKH type 1 is isolated Müllerian agenesis, while MRKH type 2 is Müllerian agenesis with another associated congenital anomaly. It is very important that girls with MRKH are evaluated for associated anomalies, which can be identified in up to 50% of patients. Renal, urinary, and skeletal anomalies, specifically scoliosis, are most common and should be assessed with a kidney ultrasound and spinal X-ray. Patients with MRKH can be referred to pediatric and adolescent gynecology at Children's Hospital Colorado for support and counseling, management of uterine remnants, vaginal creation, or fertility counseling. Psychosocial support is important for all patients with MRKH. Coping with the loss of fertility and differences in the reproductive tract can be especially difficult for young patients. Girls with MRKH may experience anxiety, depression, grief, or anger associated with their diagnosis. At Children's Hospital Colorado, we offer consultation with a psychologist experienced in helping patients with complex medical conditions that involve the genital and reproductive tract. We also stress the value of support groups. Beautiful You MRKH is a national support group for women with MRKH. They host patient conferences across the country and are active on social media platforms like Instagram and Facebook. Fertility and options for family building should be discussed with all patients. With normal functioning ovaries, girls with MRKH may utilize assisted reproductive technology with use of a gestational carrier. Adoption is another option. Management of the underdeveloped vagina should only be considered when it's desired by the patient. There is no optimal time for vaginal creation, as every girl is unique with different motivations and different interests. The first-line approach for vaginal creation is primary vaginal elongation by dilation. In girls that are ready, emotionally mature, and motivated, dilation is successful 90% of the time. Although there are minimal risks with vaginal dilation, the process may take anywhere from 3 to 12 months, with frequent visits to monitor progress and troubleshoot any difficulties. Before starting vaginal dilation, I have my patient order a set of 4 to 5 dilators. There are a variety of options online, but my preference is to use Syracuse dilators. These have a blunted tip and are made of latex-free, medical-grade firm plastic. Patients receive instruction for vaginal dilation in the clinic to assure that they are comfortably and correctly inserting the dilator. She is advised to insert the dilator into the distal vagina with pressure for 10 to 20 minutes, 1 to 2 times daily. When adequate length is achieved with the smallest dilator, the next size is started. Girls should have privacy for dilation and support when needed. Any vaginal bleeding or pain will be evaluated in the clinic. In our practice, success of vaginal dilation is defined by function and not necessarily by length. Surgical creation of the vagina is reserved for patients who cannot or fail vaginal dilation. There are several surgical techniques to create a vagina, many of which are offered at Children's Hospital Colorado. The laparoscopic Vecchietti procedure lengthens native vagina with use of a vaginal mold and an abdominal traction device. Alternatively, vaginoplasty can be performed with the use of a graft, such as bowel, buccal mucosa, or peritoneum. Regardless of the technique, postoperative dilation is necessary to maintain vaginal patency and length. Our gynecologists at Children's Hospital Colorado are dedicated to helping young women with MRKH by providing support, counseling, and management options for Müllerian and vaginal agenesis. For more information, visit our website.